Hi, this is Dr. Paul with Online Chiropractic Marketing Systems. We're going to do a real quick abbreviation check for the competition of a keyword. The keyword we're looking at right here is Fort Lauderdale Chiropractor. We went ahead and hit search, and you can see number one, our competition for that is 291,000, which is pretty good as long as it's under a certain amount. That looks good. And then when we come in here, we see this is number one, number two, number three. So let's go ahead and evaluate. This is number one right here. And that's her site. First thing that I'm going to notice here is a couple things. Is number one, that it's not a blog. So I'm going to evaluate the site first. So let's go ahead and look at the page source. There's seven components that I'm going to look at. First, I'm going to look at the title tag and see if she has the keywords in the title tag. And of course she does. She's going after Fort Lauderdale, Wilton Manors, Oakland Park, and chiropractor. So it's very clean what she's going after, which is very good. Then I'm going to look at the meta keywords. We'll look at those here. Second, you can see the description. Donna Watson, chiropractic offices. So once again, she's going after those very specific keywords. And you can see here the meta keywords. Fort Lauderdale Chiropractor, Wilson Manor Chiropractor, Oakland Park Chiropractor. And back pain, Fort Lauderdale Chiropractor. Back pain, Wilton Manors. So she's sticking with, as you can see here, back pain, Fort Lauderdale Chiropractor, back pain. So she's sticking with three different proximity-based keywords, Fort Lauderdale, Wilton Manors, and Oakland Park. Then she's going after the back pain gateway. And in here, you can see she's also going after back pain relief, including those proximity-based keywords. So very clean, very concise. She's not trying to be everything to everybody. Very focused, which is good. Then I'm going to look for an H1 tag. So we got the meta, we got the title, we got the meta description, meta keywords. We're going to come down here, and we're going to look for the H1 tag, and it starts right inside the body. So we're going to jump on down here, take a look at a couple things here. Let's come back up. So here's the end of the head. So from here up is the head. The body starts right here. So I'm going to start looking for my H1 and H2 tags. Now I'm going to come down here, and I do not see, it'll say literally right in this area here, here, and here, H1, H2 tags. So I am not seeing an H1, H2 tag. So she has not demarcated an H1, H2 tag, which tells me that that's just from lack of experience and confidence. Also, the images, she's using GIF images, which is fine, but they're not keyworded at all, so they're just listed as an image. So the images that she's using, here's another one right here, do not have the keyword in it. So that's another characteristic. So we looked at the title tags, meta description, meta keywords, H1, H2 tags, and the indexes. So I'm seeing not very good on-page optimization. I'm also noticing that this is not a blog. This is a static site. It has some static components here to it. And you can see they're essentially just articles. One thing that I don't like, she has this tells me it's inexperienced. She has two navigator links with links instead of one with links. And she has a lot of links on here. And this is very bad for SEO. You do not want those kind of links going out of your website. So that's also a sign of lack of sophistication relative to the product. So no blog, and I'm also not seeing any gateways per se. She's talking about chiropractic. Why really patients don't really care about chiropractic. Talks about her treatment. Only got her links there. When to seek care. Nobody looks Google subluxations. Got a couple products. Here you can see she has some tips. These are essentially looks like just some articles, generic articles that she's included. And nobody's going to a website to look at a spine. And you can see there's no real good videos or sales copy, problem solution, why you offer deadline, and nobody really cares too much about the glossary. So very unsophisticated site here as far as SEO purposes and sales copy. So that's the same link we put in here. I'm evaluating the site from this spot right here. So actually that's not the one right there. This is the one right here, and let's go ahead and get the information on that. So this is her particular site right here, a place of health. And let's make sure we've got this what we want here. That's the second one. That's the second one. Okay. So let me come back over to our site here. And let's go right here. And let's pull this up and evaluate it specifically. So this is the home page of the site right here. You can see the title tags. We've already talked about the keywords and the title tags in the meta description. Page rank 3, that's pretty good for a small page, what I'm looking at here. These are the domain name information, but specifically what I'm looking at is right here is backlinks. And you can see she's got quite a few backlinks, 191, what was that, 143. So she's definitely putting work into the backlinks, and that's why she's on the first page of Google, and she has 47 pages. So she does have several pages on her site, which tells me that it is being worked to some degree. I'm going to go ahead and evaluate these pages. We'll come down here, scroll through them. Here's what I'm noticing right away. You see this right here, likeme.net, likeme.net, likeme. So she's going to a similar site routinely, and you can see what it is here. Allie's Bar, Hound's Pub, Marguerite's Hill, Angelisa's Pub. So what she's doing is going into these sites, creating comments on these sites and putting her backlinks in is what's happening with that. Of course, she has a directory here. Something of that nature, and then you come on down. So that's the majority of her sites are like me, like me, like me, and that's what she's doing. So that tells me, again, lack of sophistication. It's very singular in her approach to SEO. Now she does have another one right here called South Florida. Okay, that's not it. I'm looking for similarities. Okay, now here we are. We see SouthFloridaFun.com. And you can see she's doing a lot of work relative to the Florida gay and lesbian community. And she's getting a lot of backlinks relative to that community. So it's very narrow and focused what she's doing with her backlinks, which tells me she is doing some work, but it's very limited in her paradigm and vision for SEO, and it's not very diverse. So that's specifically what I'm looking for in the backlink categories. Now what's interesting is when I went from this site was number one. This was actually the number two site. When I go to number two site and evaluate it, that's this right here. Look how far we've jumped down. We go from right here. Let me show you this right here. This is kind of important. Okay, this was her site right here. We went from 143 backlinks essentially right there to this guy right here. This was the number two site. And let's go ahead and look at his title tag, what he's going for. Fort Lauderdale chiropractor, chiropractor, back pain, neck pain. He's also including neck pain relief, auto accident injuries, Fort Lauderdale, okay. Keywords, a lot more, Fort Lauderdale chiropractor, chiropractic, back pain. So you can see here, auto injury, inland vital care, whiplash, pain management, massage therapy. So he's going after several more keywords. And remember, the more varied you get, the less effective you are. How good is his keyword description? Fort Lauderdale chiropractor, his keywords. He's including auto accident car injuries. Okay, so then we come down here, and we're going to go check out his backlinks. Remember now, we went from this category of backlinks right here for page one. Remember, this was page one right here, this lady, right? Let me make sure we get the right one here. Okay, so that was page one for this lady right here. This was number one, 143 backlinks to this one right here. He's number two, and this is it right here, 36. See how quickly we dropped? And so when we come down to this site, we can also evaluate his pages, etc. So we're looking at his backlinks, 36 backlinks. How many pages does he have? He's got only 14 pages with 36 backlinks. So again, I'm not seeing, and there's quite a drop from number one to number two, which tells me the competition is dropping off significantly and very fast. That's what that tells me. So that's what we're looking at when we're evaluating the site.